episode? Question mark. I don't know. But here we are, inside of the dream world, the ghost world, whatever you may call it. Throughout the game, we've spent time unlocking all these other four side temples. The Squid Temple. I believe that's the Shark Temple. The Whale Temple. And the Manta Ray Temple. But now, this time in the ghost world, not humans, but real living things. I don't know, by activating this, will we bring them back to life? On some of the hieroglyphs that we saw earlier, we saw the four little temples and that main temple, and above them, the whales, the rays, the squid, and the sharks. But above the center main temple was the great white shark. The same great white shark that sacrificed his life trying to attack the pyramid core. Maybe this will bring answer our questions, or just leave more to be desired. Almost 5 minutes in. Enough dawdling, right? Enough stalling, enough talking. And yet here I'm doing it again. On purpose, I may suspense, you know. But if we have the triangle inside of us, the triangle was attacking nature, why are we bringing it back? Why are we different? What can we bring to life? We still have the strange red vortex below us. Looks ominous and frightening. Could it be some of the source of the trouble in this area with the dead fauna and missing plants that we've been working so hard to restore? In the last room we saw before taking the real-life incarnation of this room. It was the same ceiling as in the actual civilization place. It was an actual room, an actual temple that had some sort of portal at the floor. What's the importance of that room? Okay. This might just set off a chain of events that leads to the end of this game. Are you ready for that? I better hope so. Swim close. And activate it. We take our soul and infuse it. And it brings to life the Great White, the ghost of the Great White is here, swimming around us. Our friend is alive. He helped us. Oh, and my skin is refurbished as well. I don't believe I was always orange either. He swam into the red. So am I, after I'm diving deep down. Swimming down, I'm following the Great White down and down and down and down and down. We emerge on the other side, 50 feet into the air, fall back down to the water. I am now cold. I don't believe I was cold. I was yellow and black swimsuit before. That were ripped from the explosion and shock. Restored. I'm revitalized. The shark is revitalized. We're in some new, crazy, beautiful, beautiful world. Bright music is playing. Beautiful pink trees all around us. There are fish swimming in the ocean. Birds flying in the sky, beautiful pink leaves in the water's arch, rock archways over the water, large mountains and towers, birds everywhere. This place is full and humming with life, and the shark is following me. I see there is a shell on this rock outcropping. I can grab onto. Maybe I have to dive deep down and then dive up in the air. Get some speed and dive up. Well, that didn't really work too well. Maybe. Can I ride the shark? I didn't realize you can hold a B to do like a, some sort of cannonball effect. You do a little flip, and if I do a flip, the shark does a flip as well. It's like he's copying me. If I swim, hold B, do a little spin. Whoa, he just dived up in the air. I spin, he spins. That's so cute. The shark's my buddy. Together we're going to beat whatever is affecting this place. He attacked us. Oh, I rode him. I just got an achievement called Connection. We have a connection together now. I believe we do. This shark is awesome. Not sure exactly how to get to that shell, but that's okay. There's more important things to do, I imagine. If I swim, oh, this shark is so cool. My flips and spins that he does with me. This place is beautiful. So let's think how I got here. At the bottom of the dream world, there was that ominous red portal. When I put my soul into the center of dream world, ball, it restored the great white shark. Shark's the best. Alright, let's dive back down though. Oh, here's a jet stream current. We're going quick. We're bursting through. Hold on. So we just jet streamed. There's this broken pyramid here. One of the evil pyramids, which is jet-streamed and broke through one part of it. Can we hit it? This broken pyramid has four parts to it, and we can swim into it and break them. Break the chains. And with that, the pyramid turned into grass and a new tree sprung forth. Releasing them again, or was the entirety of the first part of the game all a dream? All of that was a dream. But now this time we're releasing them for real. And we can explore. No, I guess you can't actually go out that far. That's okay. I did see it raise the water level, too. So I bet if we go back to the first area, we'll be able to pick up that shell that was just out of reach. We can take the riptide back. Oops, actually, this took us to a... I thought I was going back the way we came. Pushing me back. So it It actually took us to a new pyramid. What if I rode the shark? Maybe he can overcome the riptide. I guess not. Oh well, that's fine. I'm gonna ride the shark and destroy the parts of this pyramid. Boom. 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 And out of it comes another tree. And the orcas come out. The place is vibrant once more. Managed to restore him back to life. If I press B on the shark, I can do spins with him, and it's awesome. Three, one more to break for this pyramid. Sharks. Can't quite recall. Oh yes. Also, are these actually pyramids? Because I thought pyramids have a square base and four triangle sides. Because that's what, like, the pyramids in Egypt are, right? Or am I misremembering? Oh man, now I really need to know. Okay, I had to look this up. A pyramid is a structure whose outer surfaces are triangular and converge to a single point at the top, making the shape roughly a pyramid in the geometric sense. The base of a pyramid can be trilateral, quadrilateral, or shape. So it doesn't matter what the base is, as long as the main sides that lead to the point are triangular. So this is a pyramid. I hope you were able to learn something from these videos today. I know I just learned something. See, my videos are informative too. It feels so good to be working with the Great White to help out the other animals and bring them back to life. Swimming through the jellyfish caves, and it does bring us to another pyramid. This one actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so that's like 6 pieces to it. We're now in a cave. We're in one of the dark caves inhabited by jellyfish. Swarm of other fish. Now I thought we brought these places back to life. Are we bringing new areas back to life? Or do we not really do them before? But this time we are. Okay. Let's do this. That makes two. So happy we're jumping out of the water. 6. And the last tree comes out of this one. The place is revitalized. The squid grows. And this place is brought back to life. And it's beautiful. They're all beautiful. Even this hunk of metal that was the pyramid looks beautiful, like some sunken ship. Now that it's covered in life, where it came to destroy life, it now facilitates new life. The squids are back. All 4 trees and the respective animals are brought back to life. Where will the next path lead us? Back to the great white shark. Which also, are we riding the real great white shark? Because this shark came out of the dream world. We saw dream. Is he helping us do this as a dream? Or is he actually fully back to life? Because if you view him straight on from the back, he glows pretty bright, almost like a phantom or apparition. And what are we? Yeah, like, what is this place? We came from the dream world to this place. Maybe this is still part of the dream world. Maybe we are in the dream world. And the redness was corruption. And we had to go through and find the corruption at the depths of the green world. Maybe when we go through this next area, it will be... Oops. My controller died. Just plug it in real fast. You don't want your interruptions and calming music. Jumping to the moon. We just jumped with the whales. Other fishes are jumping and we're swimming in circles. Everything is following us. Oh, I didn't notice this until now. Wherever I swim, there's a huge line of fish that is following. The fish believe in us as well. It kind of has the same wispy air to it. Oh. Whoa. The whales. The whales are jumping too. Oh no, actually let go of the shark. Come back, shark. I want to ride you. Shark, come back. We're in this together, shark. Even the whales. I'm riding the giant, giant blue whale. It's awesome. All the fish, all the animals are coming together. Jumping out of the water. It's magical. Back on the great white, he's ecstatic. It's amazing. All the creatures of the sea are coming together on this task. And on top of us, we see the half-destroyed remains of what looks to be the final. This is such an awesome scene right here. Sorry, I'm not going in, but seeing all the whales dive is breathtaking. It's just so cool with all the fish following us. Is that a shale over there? Way. Looks like there's a little tiny island out here. Anything on that island? What? It's some polar bears and penguins with a shell. Awesome. I need to climb on this. We see a little glacier area where there's a bunch of penguins and a polar bear and a shell. I got an achievement, Arctic Explorer. This even looks like one of those little camera dudes around here. And a block of ice. Maybe this is another social commentary on sort of the technology going against nature. bears and not the polar bears eating the penguins. Though they live on different sides, Arctic and Antarctic. But there's not much else for them. They're almost trapped here by themselves. It's the maybe heat of this pyramid melting on the ice. Perhaps a rift on human-made global warming. Let's dive back into the water. Let the shark go. Come here, shark. Some dive. Okay, I think everybody's ready. I think everybody's ready to take on the final core, or what I assume is the final fight. I just want to see one more whale dive. Beautiful. Okay. Let's swim with the shark into the core. We will complete this. We will stop this. Oh, I don't think he could go in with me. Sure, buddy, you can't come with me. Looks like he's not able to go in. Only I am. Maybe because this is a dream. Oh, is that little fisher coming with me? But I have to make this journey myself, I guess. And we're swimming in. And we're just, oh, I'm swimming with the shark. And instead of being blown up by the mines, we're just breaking them all. These mines won't stop us. We're strong. We're powerful. And here we go. At the center core. And we're flying at the speed of light. And we hit it. And it's gone. And trees and moss. It's becoming a haven for life. Life has returned. The red core shuts down. And it's done. It's done. And that is the end of the game. And it's done. Are rolling for all the great people who put so much time and effort in seeing their dream reality. There's a shell here. Am I able to pick it up? Maybe this is the final shell. I believe it is. And that beautiful, beautiful music by Austin Winteroy. Set my controller down and think about this for a little bit. So in my mind, the pyramids are the one that came and wiped out the civilizations. That's why we saw everything so empty and deserted. It was robots the whole time. We had that I'm just trying to make the connection between. We had the triangle in our chest. And in some of the hieroglyphs, some people had triangles and some didn't. Was it? Were the people that didn't have the triangles, were they not robots? Were they actual living things? By giant squid games. So of course they had to have one of the temples trees be squid themed. It makes sense. Press start. Are we the same as the original? With the original robot-looking people with triangles in their chest as well? Were we the last survivor? Because the game starts with us kind of just in the middle of the ocean. It doesn't say how we got there. We almost seemed like we were hundreds of years in the future. This was some ancient, long-lost civilization. Thank you.
Have a super.